Satnam, Aman Devi here, offering a general reading. As always, explore what resonates within. Got some song lyrics coming to mind. Those are in the description box for you to take a look at. Listen if you want. And this deck was calling out. So I feel like with this deck coming through, it's like, how are your angels there for you? And how can you tune into their frequency to receive from them? A reminder that you have free will and they won't intervene without your permission. And so sometimes it requires you understanding where you're at to ask for what you need. Yeah, sometimes we don't know what we need. So in that moment of uncertainty, fear, doubt, loathing, or wherever your pitfall is that you're starting to notice a spiral down, can you stop and breathe so that you start to come into the physical body, right? To move the energy, ground yourself, notice your feet, and notice your surroundings and allow yourself to see. And so sometimes in that moment, they can deliver to you as you ask. But instead, the mind starts spinning, right? And we go into that pattern. And the emotions captivate us. And there is no way of seeing clearly once we're held captive, right? And so they're asking for you to notice that they're there and to deliver to them. Like, I say divine delivers, but it's like, allow them to pick up the package. Allow them to take your doubt. Allow them to transmute the energies for you, right? And so getting clear, crystal clear about what you need and what you want to see. And when I say get clear about what you want to see, it's like you have to want more for yourself than what you have grown accustomed to. Because that is part of your incarnation. Your incarnation has brought you to one level, and you have the opportunity to rise up. And the idea of gaming came to mind, and I'm not a gamer. I played like basic Nintendo and loved Atari because it was so simple. But it's like you go through level to level, right? No problem. You don't think anything of it, of losing a man and then starting over again, right? Why would it be any different through the mind or through you in this lifetime? Why do we push ourselves down with doubt? Because we've given ourselves, or the divine has given us, another opportunity to learn. We go in different stages of development, right? Of human development. We go in different stages in the educational system, right? So at the soul level, there are different stages of your growth. And that happens through humans. It happens through your ahas. It happens through you feeling the divine with you and feeling those emotions that feel so heavy and cumbersome. And that's what they want you to give them. You're like, this guilt, this shame, this doubt, I give it to you to take from me. And then as they clear that from you, like Ten of Wands energy, how can you see? Because now your arms aren't burdened holding all those wands, right? So let's take a look at what the cards have to say. You have free will. The divine will intervene. Oh my gosh, I've given the divine permission to intervene, and then I'm kind of like, whoa, they really did. But you have to give them access. And it requires your understanding to hand that over. It's like, I'm trying to think of how to say this, because it came to mind earlier today. Okay, now they're bringing me back to another. Okay. So when you come into the moment of you, right, you come in that moment that you're like, something needs to shift. I notice where I'm at, and this isn't where I want to stay because I know I belong, right? I belong in this planet, and yet my emotions and the mental turning is telling me I don't in some way, right? Because that's what fear, shame, doubt, and self-loathing is. It's telling, you're telling yourself that you don't belong on some level, right? But you do. And so how do you free yourself from that shame to see anew, to see that the divine is here for you? And so sometimes that requires some movement. It might require a drive. It might require a walk. It might require a soundboard, a song, whatever it is for you, to journal, so that the mind isn't taking over with all its tricks, because that's all it is tricks. Because your perception of reality is a fixation of the mind, right? It's this categorization. I'm seeing like a Tetris, right? The way the mind's like, oh, we have to organize it this way, right? So that the human can be comfortable, right? But the soul says, no, mind, we don't need to be comfortable. We need to be free. It's a lack of understanding that keeps you captive in the mind. And what do you need to do? It's process oriented to see it. So another thing was coming up is like when I was thinking about the educational system, and I'm not, you know, you could go in at different directions than I'm going in, but think about this. At each milestone, at each category, whether elementary, middle, high school, right, college, master's, whatever it is, category you are in, you have like, oh my gosh, it seems like these days you get your fancy cupcake in your party, right? So how can you celebrate your win? How can you celebrate your newfound freedom, your new awareness, your new aha, right? All right, so let's take a look at this. You have a choice. You have a choice of who you connect to and how you see yourself. I'm seeing a vase. Greek mythology. If you know Greek mythology, because I'm kind of, my mind's eye kind of shifted from the shape of a vase to seeing the black and orange depictions on a vase. So if you know Greek mythology, perhaps there's something to explore there. It's the story we tell ourselves, or the stories that were once told to keep the human happy or to keep the human in check, right? And so we have these myths and these stories, seeing golden books now. It's a way that you no longer have to qualify and quantify your experiences in the way that the mind once categorized them. It's now about opening up, and nudity not so much in terms of sex and sexuality, rather vulnerability, and how deeply are you willing to connect to another human being that the divine has delivered to you to learn and grow through. And it's your choice to step into that connection and shed your layers of shame to see yourself anew, and not how the brain has categorized you based on societal construct. Three of Cups. This world is worth celebrating. You, my dear, are worth celebrating. And what will you commit to? What higher order is in the mind's eye? And what is the heart saying? I love you, dear soul. I'm going to share a piece from a reading I've given because it stood out to me so much. And I normally don't share what I get in personal readings. I'm not going to name a name, but her message was, have you been reckless with your own heart? And there's a difference between reckless with your heart and just so freely giving it away. And there's another way that we kind of put up all these walls around us because we're like, I'm not going to get hurt again. That's not happening again. And the more that you say that's not happening again and you put up that wall, you're going to repeat the same parallel experience until you open up to live and learn that experience. Does that make sense? Like, you have to learn the lesson and open up to it and transmute it before you see a new human on your path, a new type of human. You know, we talk about the type, you have that pattern or cycle. And each time that you make a new choice to love and commit to your sovereignty on this divine path, that is worth celebrating. That is your pearl of wisdom. This is your golden opportunity. I feel like that's come up in another reading, and I'm only saying this because of the deck that I have in my hand. How are you celebrating life? Like, your existence on this planet? And it's not like YOLO, never, you only live once. It's more like, I'm worth celebrating. This moment is worth celebrating. This connection is worth celebrating. This choice to commit to my sovereignty is worth celebrating. Change. Managing the emotions and the mental body. I feel like we talk about this a lot. The breakthrough moment is here. And it requires you to understand how your emotions work, to teach you what emotions you lay to rest, what emotions have you spiraling that you need to shift out of. What needs to be laid to rest in the mental body? And how can you rest assured that your angels have your back? And they always have. And it doesn't always feel like that. Because they've been putting you through some lessons. Let me tell you what. But it's, how long will you repeat the cycle? How long will you be in, I want to say, the Queen of Cups energy. And this is not to disregard the Queen. The King also has its pitfalls, as in hiding his emotions and withholding. And sometimes that's necessary. Think of a parent, right? You have to dial back and deliver to allow your child to understand, right? The Queen of Hearts can have this outpour of emotions like a martyr, right? There is a balance between what you feel and what needs to be discussed. And this is not to say there shouldn't be open lines of communication, healthy lines. Sometimes, what do we need to check within and self-regulate, and what needs to come together as part of the union? There's like, think of basic human communication. There's your truth, my truth, and there's the truth, okay? And so the Queen of Hearts only thinks of like her truth as their truth, whereas the King pulls back so much. He only thinks of their truth. There is a balance. Got two falling out. What is your intuition telling you? Sunset. What if this is the last day you see the sun? How would you live? What is, if this is the last night you saw your lover, what would you say? How will you begin anew, like a new day, a new dawn? I think that's from Nina Simone. I was listening to her today. Will you choose to let the fears rest and make a choice to celebrate life and commit to loving life, loving your partner, loving your job, loving your children, whatever it is. The frustrations are deep, you know? It's easy to get frustrated. But that's where the King of Hearts is really good at recognizing how you're thinking about a situation and redirecting the emotions for the greater good of all. And it's time. It's time to live life like there's no tomorrow. Sending lots of love and light your way. Send them.